Yangtze River has played a crucial role in the country's development over thousands of years by providing water for crops and being used as a means of transportation. Regarded as one of the cradles of Chinese civilization, cultural heritage flourished along its banks, becoming home to a variety of ancient treasures. In Chinese, we call it Changjiang, which means the long river. And actually, it is indeed the longest river in China, measuring 6,300 kilometers. From the map, it actually starts somewhere here, running through Qinghai, Tibet, Transkei region, Sichuan, Yunnan, Chongqing, Hubei, Hunan, Jiangxi, Anhui, Jiangsu, and finally through Shanghai to the East China Sea. The upper reaches stretch from its headwaters in the Tangula Mountains all the way to Yichang in Hubei province. And the central Yangtze reaches are from Yichang to Hukou of Jiangxi province, and the lower Yangtze runs from Hukou to Shanghai. The banks of the Yangtze River are where many regional cultures have flourished. Bashu in the southwest, Chu in the central region, and Wuyue in the east. More than 40 World Heritage Sites, World Heritage Irrigation Structures, and globally important agricultural heritage systems can be found along the river. For example, the Liangzhu ruins in Zhejiang province have gained recognition as proof Chinese civilization existed at least 5,000 years ago. The Sanxingdui ruins in Guanghan, Sichuan province are believed to be the remnants of the Shu kingdom, which dates back over 4,000 years. Archaeological discoveries along the Yangtze have shown it was used to trade with the outside world. Let's start our treasure hunt along the river so as to understand how ancient Chinese traded and interacted with other peoples.
Well, I think we've just arrived at the perfect place to get our treasure hunt started. The Yangtze River is often referred to as China's golden waterway because trade between China and foreign countries was born and flourished along the river. I don't know about you, but when I think treasure, I think money. So what kind of currency the ancient Chinese used to trade?
Well, this isn't exactly what I was hoping for, but the 3,000-year-old Sanxingdui ruins in Guanghan of Sichuan province have unearthed many of these seashells from Indian Ocean. That means in ancient Shu kingdom, now it's in Sichuan province, had already established trade connections with the outside world using these seashells as currency.
这可以说明就早在商周时期几千年前中国的这个内陆已经和海外尤其是这个印度洋沿岸印度东南亚等地有非常密切的这种文化交流可以说明我们今天的这个全球化在当时可以说各国各地之间的这种交流就已经是有一个苗头在了三星堆遗址出土的这些海贝呢它有很大的比例都是这种环纹货币 而且这种环纹货币呢是经过人工的加工处理的它是有一个磨平然后还有一些可以穿孔就方便人们把它们穿信起来因为夏商时期比较久远当时这个人工货币应该还没有出现和流通所以呢这个海贝呢在三星堆遗址它也是在古蜀文明当中也是比较难得的所以呢它主要是用于一种上层阶级的这样一种财富的象征而在中下层的普通民众呢其实当时主要还是使用一种物物交换的 这样一种交易方式。
As human society evolved, coins were invented. I found a treasure almost entirely decorated in coins. This item is a money tree, and it was discovered in a tomb in Sichuan province. It dates back to the Eastern Han Dynasty, which coincides with the period of the Roman Empire.
In ancient China, the legendary money tree shed coins when shaken and still represents good fortune today. This artifact unearthed in Nianyang of Sichuan province is 1.5 meters tall. Its base is made of pottery clay, and the body, including these branches and leaves, are made of bronze. The decorative birds, fairies, mythical creatures, and copper coins are very typical for a money tree of the time, reflecting people's common wish of becoming wealthy. It also proved how important commerce was during Eastern Han Dynasty.
This这个摇钱树我们也看它的制作是比较精细的，而且这么大一株青铜浇筑的树，所以我们可以想象，一般的普通老百姓家庭是没有办法使用的。所以呢，在当时主要就是上层的贵族阶级或者是比较有钱的人才能够使用这样一种陪葬品。一方面就是，希望能够借助这种通天通地的这样一种神树来实现自己长生不死，或者是来世幸福的这样一种祈愿；另一方面呢，树上的这些铜钱也是代表了这个墓主人也好，他对他的后世的子孙也好，希望能够拥有财富的这样一种愿望。那这种神树崇拜呢，其实不止在中国属地，在其他中国的其他地区，还有世界其他地区都有这种类似的神树崇拜。可能不一定是跟古蜀文明同一时期的，在这个古印度啊，也有这种青铜的神树；在西亚等地也有这种神树的传说。
Well, that was both educational and fun. Please join me for part 2 of the series as I flow through the middle reaches of the Yangtze River and find some more of its little-known treasures.
密码，所有的三大招，我昨天晚上都睡不着，停不下来。我每次看这种都很焦虑，我多看一下呀，催着我走，快听我的。